we're going to take a look at a new addition to the Knightsbridge grid switch range.
You know, when a box from Knightsbridge turns up, there's a little bit of innovation in there.
There sure is. And where would you like to take us, Gordon?
Well, Knightsbridge have solved one of those problems, Gary. So when I think about fan isolators for bathroom extractor fans, what do you think?
I think of that really large switch above the door, pretending it's not there, but actually really large and probably visual from the bedroom if it's an ensuite.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of those. And then the next problem, you know, you're in an environment where you want decorative wiring accessories. Can you get the colour you want?
Probably not, no.
Yeah, probably won't. What about the fusing option?
You meant to fuse them down?
Well, depends on the instructions. So Knightsbridge have solved all of these problems with, in addition to the grid switch range.
You can't have picked it up.
Yep.
You definitely can't have picked it up because it is three pole. There's a neutral switching line and line in there, and you've put up a single module grid switch.
Yeah, and this is the innovation. So here it is.
That is tiny.
There's three poles in there.
Yeah,
and there's a 10 amp rated switch. Yeah.
Can you flip it over for me? Just have a look at the other side as well. Yeah. Wow. That is small.
Yeah. And they've also solved another problem.
Another problem? I didn't realise there was another problem.
Well, some people just switch those isolators off, Gary.
Okay. Well, maybe they're in a hotel room, they go to the bathroom, they want to get into bed next, and it's going to run for 20 minutes, and they're perhaps savvy enough to understand what that large switch above the door is, and they go and turn it off.
Yeah, they go and turn it off. So the innovation in this range is obviously got the regular switch version, but we've now got a secret key switch version as well.
All right. So in that case, if you put that into a hotel room, I couldn't do that, or it'd be very difficult. I'd have to, you know, perhaps search through my keys to see if I've got one of them on it.
Yeah.
And also rented property. Is again, isn't it?
Yeah, again, where people unintentionally or deliberately switch them off and stay off for a long time, so you end up with condensation problems and things like that. So building this range into a grid switch obviously solves lots of problems. The first one being you don't necessarily have to have the big switch above the bathroom door.
Oh, that'd be a miss, won't it?
Yeah, so what I've done here is I've integrated it here into a triple gang plate.
Right.
So that's what we've got here, linked to this fan.
And the fuse, so I'm thinking there that when I look in the manufacturer's instructions for some fans, it says not to be on that 5 or 6 amp lighting circuit and to be fused down individually, is that right?
Yeah, the fuse is down to the manufacturer's instructions. So yeah, you can have a fuse, you can have your functional light switch, and then integrated into there, obviously put the secret key switch. So yeah, can save your wiring time, don't need that additional box.
So when I turn this, the fan will come on?
Hopefully, yes.
Oh, it does?
Yeah. obviously I've paired this with some Knightsbridge fans, so they also make the fans as well in coordinated colours to match the range.
Very nice black one as
well. Yeah, so black apparently at the minute is one of those on-trend
colours. Tell me it's the new white.
It is the new white, yeah. So I've got that, so you've switched the light on, the fans come on, switch it off, and as you expect, run on timer.
And now I'm in my hotel room.
Yeah, and I just, yeah, so if you're in your hotel room, you can't switch it off, but if you want to do some maintenance, we've got the secret key switch in there, and we can, isolate it.
So by operating that, that's operate all three poles again?
Yeah, exactly.
Wow, that is tiny and really clever, and I love the two applications you gave there, rented properties and hotel rooms where you really want to leave it running on, don't you?
Yeah, I'm not a fan of the big switch above the door, just integrating it possibly if you don't need the fuse, or you could put the fuse somewhere else into a dual gang plate next to the bathroom or a toilet door.
Okay, we also looked at a metal clad range, didn't we? And we said in that range that maybe that would be local to the extractor system. Should we cut to that?
Yeah, let's have a look. So let's look at a practical application with this whole house ventilation system.
So the fan isolator is local along with the appropriate size fuse as per manufacturer's instructions. And as this is eFIXX, I noticed the flexible cable there has a ferrule on it.
Yeah, like a nice, secure, reliable connection.
So to make those connections off, we've obviously got our neutral, our switching line and our permanent line connections going in.
Yep, so permanent line's fed via the fuse. But I thought this local isolator is really essential for this whole house ventilation because in there there's filters, there's some sensors to set the moisture level and things like that. So you would need to isolate it locally to perform mechanical and electrical maintenance.
Okay, that makes sense. So just pop the remaining cables in and then we can put our fan isolator into our grid mounting frame. And am I right in thinking it goes in bottom first and hinges into the top?
Yes, just hinge so they are labelled top. So you can obviously get the switch round the right way up. So just click them in and then bring in the frame for the metal clad finish.
So front plate goes on. Yeah. I'm expecting these screws to be horizontal or vertical. What are you going for?
Well, just have to wait and see.
All right, the surprise.
But I've used this with a mini trunking and a handy adapter that adapts the mini trunking to the knockout in the top of that metal clad box.
I almost didn't notice it, so it shows you how good that is.
Yeah, so hopefully that should create a tidy installation.
For vertical, and as we step back, so that's a whole house ventilation system, probably housed in a cupboard within the installation, local isolation. Is it okay if you show us some of this assembly process that you went through?
Yeah, so again, I've got the let's build a stealthy black version up here. So the York itself will accommodate up to 4 switches, but obviously the fan scenarios here, we've got 3, including the fuse. So it comes with this handy spacer module, so you can get it exactly spaced for 3 modules. So I'll take our fuse module.
You're going in with the black, that's matte black, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the matte black.
They do it in matte white, they do it in white, they also do it in polished and brushed chrome, am I right in thinking that?
That's right, yeah. So we've got these different finishes here.
Let's have a little look.
The chrome, yeah. And again, with the screwless and the raised front plates and the flat plates as well. So yeah, so this is compatible with all of the range.
And what are you building up for me here?
So I've built up a version in black, which is obviously fuse, a switch and fan isolator. Now again, if this was the functional switch for the bathroom, you'd probably go for the key switch option there.
Okay,
as well.
Yeah, what we did, yeah, and then you clip that together.
And then you just click your front on and I've got a nice stealthy switch. And I can match that up with this black fan as well.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I like that. I wouldn't suggest it's the new white. It's a little bit dark for the new white. But that's, in the right place. That's a lovely looking colour, isn't it?
Yeah, I think they've solved a problem that's out there, and yeah, that should keep a lot of people happy and make electricians' lives easier.
Yeah, well, and we like that at eFIXX. But as always, we're interested in your comments. Have you fitted one of these fan isolators that goes in a single module of a grid switch from Knightsbridge already? Are you thinking about fitting them in the future? Is it something you think's brilliant, and why didn't you think of it before? Because that's what we thought of, didn't we, when it came in. Are you currently fitting a fuse to downgrade your fan because the manufacturer's instructions require it? Please leave those comments below. Is there something in the Knightsbridge range that you think's an absolute gem and you'd like us to review it? Again, leave that in the comments. Me and Gordon will try and get back to as many as we can.